Hello, my name is Andy Bond. What is up, ladies and gentlemen? This is time to talk with the news guy. The news guy is on my show. The news guy is going to ask me any question that he wants to hear from the drama. So, news guy, take it away.
Now, what I want to know is, why does Angela Truth, why does she believe that you are somehow harassing her? What kind of evidence does she have?
Oh, that she has evidence that I arrested her on my program when I said those four people. But no, I did not, because what I said to those four people yesterday, if you listen to my archives,
sure.
What you heard my archives. If you listen to my archives, I was mad. Okay.
You were very mad. When I was listening to it, I've never heard anybody that fired up before.
I was mad, but now I am doing different shows. I'm not. I don't dwell on the past. I don't dwell on the past. But for some odd reason, Angela Truth loves bringing up past stuff. And you know what? It's just like, what the heck? I did not say anything mean about Angela Truth. I did not say anything mean about Goofy Bones. I did not say anything mean about Desert. Actually, I did say something. I did say something mean to Desert Rose and Prankville USA. But the funny thing is, Prankville USA and Desert Rose doesn't know how to take crap. The funny thing is,
I don't really know if they're married or not.
I know, but the funny thing is, when Desert Rose and Prankville get threatened, they go to these two and they news every animal. What the heck is going on in today's world where you can't, where if someone makes fun of me, I'm gonna say on my radio show here. But no, I don't run to you and say, can you make fun of these people, please? I'm afraid.
Yeah, you gotta understand that Angela Truth, she's a very classic S stirrer, if you understand what I'm saying.
She is, like I said before, and I'm going to say again. Mm-hmm. Once you want ratings, so you be mean. You're ruthless. You're just plain mean to people. But when you're so high on your radio show, you're so mean, it's gonna hit the fan. Basically, it's gonna hit the fan in about 5 seconds.
Yeah.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's gonna hit the fan, because then you're not gonna have anybody. You're not gonna have anyone to blame but yourself. Or you can blame people like, oh, Andy Bond made me say this, or. But look at yourself in the mirror. Basically, look at yourself in the mirror. Listen to your archives. That's just what I do every single time. And when I make fun of people, I go back into my archives. And I listen to the archives that I made fun of W. Daily. And I can't take it back.
Yeah,
it's out there.
Let's not talk about Debbie. We'll leave Debbie out of this. Yeah. You got enough on your plate with Angela Truth, and you know, the thing is, I'm looking at this picture, this icon of Angela Truth here, and I gotta say, it does look, now that I'm looking at this more detailed, more close up, this icon of her definitely looks like she's done some sort of photo manipulation on it. You can clearly see there's been some work done on the chin. You know, she's definitely tried to make it look like she's got some narrowing down towards the chin, and tried to make it her face appear to be slimmer. At the same time, her eyes are just like gigantic, and she winds up looking like some sort of a alien thing that walked off a flying saucer somewhere.
Andy Bond showing off what he learned in math class today. Listen to the. I sound like Pee Wee Herman.
You sound like Pee Wee Herman, though.
On speed.
Yes. Now, who is this? Autism Poems. What is this?
Oh my gosh.
Hold on, let me see here. What is
Please.
This? Oh, okay. Angela Utley, Truth Talks Radio. 16 hours ago, attempting to do a show for my tub. Will I fry?
Seriously, did you know what? And the funny thing is, she deleted that episode.
She well, I'm looking at her page there, and she does. She does have a show here about. Where is it here? In the tub. In my tub, broadcasting Let's Talk, but that was from February 16th.
You know what? It's interesting because it's interesting because people think that I'm going to, if they threaten me, I'm going to back off.
Right.
But I'm not.
No.
I'm not going to back off until they back off. And you know what? I am so sorry that all this drama occurred. I wanted to get my point across for some odd reason. But when something bad happens to my friend, I will stand up. I'm sorry. Whatever I'm doing in my radio show, I will stop.
Yeah.
I will read my chat, and if someone is being mean to me, being mean to one of my friends in my chat, I will stick up for them.
That's right, you know, and that's a good thing. I think that's very nice of you. But you know what? I've got to figure out here. I got to figure out how to get Brown Beasley on my show. That guy's on a trip.
Who's Brown Beasley?
He's some guy. He's been on a lot of these shows here. He's a very classic kind of a stirrer, if you will.
Mm.
Brown Beasley. Mm. He does the talking over people and everything like this. It'd be very nice to see. Get him on the show. A good Saturday night show, I think.
Oh, yeah. So, do you have any more questions?
Well, let me see here. Okay, so we got that covered. So she said this to you yesterday, am I understanding?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we will have to see how this develops. Now, I don't think that, to be honest with you, I don't think anything is really going to happen.
Mm-mm.
I don't think that you're going to be taken off the air, and, she might have complained, but what is she going to do? I mean, what are they going to do? Nothing. Nothing's going to come out of this.
Uh-huh.
But have you heard back from Desert Rose or this?
No.
Tom
Morrison, last night on my show, on Night Talk, says, you're going to get what you get. Oh. And I'm like, seriously? And the only thing that's the funny thing, that people think and prank, and I love Tom Morrison because he's like, watch your Twitter because you're going to be begotten. You're going to get boy. You thought you could prank me? I'm going to prank you. And I'm like, seriously? And I'm being nice here. And I can go off. I can be mean. I can be mad. I can be ruthless. But I'm trying to be nice here. We are running a radio show here on your show. We're running my show here. I can't cuss on your show. I can't cuss on my show. I'm trying to be nice here. So if the legal department does hear my show, they're not going to find anything mean about I said to Angela Truth. But Angela Truth thinks that I said something mean. And the funny thing is, why I brought up W Daily, and then we brought it, because Angela Truth says, maybe W Daily and me can team up to Dollar to take you down, Andy, because you said mean things to him.
Now that would be interesting.
Angela Truth and W Daily working together.
To get rid of you.
To get rid of me. Wow, okay, seriously, I will pay. If that could happen, I will pay money to see that. How about you?
That would be hysterical.
I would laugh my head off.
There used to be some sort of a co-hosting thing as she was the sidekick or something to Debbie Daly. So.
And the funny thing is, I blocked Angela Truth from my Skype. Bathtub Girl, I blocked him from my Skype.
Well, that's good. I think that's the best thing that you could do, really, with this, somebody like Angela Truth.
But I would laugh my head off if that ever happens, that WD and Angela Truth teams up to bring me down. I would laugh my head off. How about you? Would you laugh your head off, too?
Oh, I would definitely. I would save those archives.
Oh, dude.
They would be part of my hard drive. Yes, absolutely. I would put them on the external.
Uh huh.
Permanent record.
But anyway, it's interesting because when trauma occurs, and this is a great lesson for people that are listening and wants to do speaker. This is a great lesson, and I'm going to tell you it if that's all right with you.
Go ahead.
Here's the lesson, everybody. When you work with people, you gotta make sure that whoever is listening is going to treat you right and treat you nice.
Yes.
Because if you don't have people that will treat you mean and nice, they will find someone that they want to hold on to. Like, they want to, these people, these four people go out on the internet, goes on Spreaker and says, who can we make fun of now? Basically.
And, you know, I don't know. They haven't really focused in on anybody else. I mean, yeah, they're running out of people to go after.
Oh, yeah, they're running out of... They're now on me, and you know what?
Yeah.
It's like, what the heck is going on? And someone is in my chat room. What is up? Amanda and Faberday, how are you doing? What is up?
They might go after me, you know, because I'm always having you on the show now, and, you know, I'm giving you some sort of a platform to unleash your anger.
I really don't want, to tell the truth, I really don't want to go, that's why I don't like when people go after my friends, because I will attack.
Right.
I will attack. So, if you're going after Peter Goodman, the yes. News Guy show, trust me, you think that I'm ruthless now? Just wait until I get my hands on whoever is going after my friend News Guy, because I will get ruthless, I will get mean, I will get so mad, because I will kill you, I will go after you. I'm like a bloodhound, okay?
Yeah, you gotta be careful with the words, because I heard what you almost said there. You don't want to say that.
I said bloodhound. I almost said that. You know what I almost said, I know that, but...
You
bloodhound.
Said something else, and we don't want to hear that because that's not good. We don't. That would be something that would get you kicked off a Spreaker.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Faberday and Amanda is in my chat room. It's nice to meet them. Well, what happened? And another thing that was interesting, if it's all right, because last night and Faberday and Amanda, it's the coolest thing ever. They talked to everybody.
Okay.
They talk to everybody, and the funny thing is, if it's all right with them, can I explain what happened last night in my chat?
I want to hear this. I want to hear what happened.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Faberday and Amanda, this is Peter Goodman from the News Guy, ladies and gentlemen. The News Guy show is on Exact FM Radio News. You can listen to the News Guy on Saturday.
Yes, yeah, Saturday night, 10 p.m. Google or do the Spreaker there for News Guy 2005.
Okay, I can say it. What happened was that when Amanda and Faberday gets together, they're like two chatty people. Like, hey, everybody, what's up? Desert Rose and Prankville USA thought they were lesbians.
Oh. Okay. But they're not lesbians.
No, they're friends. But the funny thing is, they want to... these people, Desert Rose, wants to make Faberday and Amanda's life a living hell. And Faberday says, go for it. And I said, go ahead. And I said it on my thing, and I'm going to say it again. If you don't want me to say it, don't say it. So Faberday says, go for it, and I'm going for it, okay? But what they said last night, that Desert Rose says, but they're lesbians. I'm like, what? That is interesting. Desert Rose thinks that Amanda and Faberday are lesbians. You know what? I can just see it right now. Faberday and I'm sorry. I can't picture Faberday and Amanda lesbians. I'm sorry. I can't.
I don't even know who these people look like.
Well, if you go into my chat...
Okay, I'm going to have to go into your chat room.
Go into my chat and look at the pictures.
Let me see here. Like the Andy Bong show. Hold on. I'm going over there right now. We got your chat room. Okay, I'm opening it up. Faberday. All right. Let me see what Faberday. I see the smaller picture. But Faberday has a different picture.
And Amanda B, and the funny thing is, it was the funniest thing ever because I was cracking up last night. I could not do my dance show because I was cracking up so much. I was laughing because Desert Rose wants to bring people down on Spreaker who comes to Spreaker for the first time ever.
Yeah, that's not good.
And you know what? I'm fed up with it. I'm literally fed up with it. And if Desert Rose has a problem, please, 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 I'm telling you right now, come to my show. Let's hash it out and be done with it. That's it. But don't send your stupid two goons, Angela Troop and Goofy Bones, to fight for you, because you know what? They're not going to do anything. They can't do anything. They don't know the story. You tell them bits and pieces, Springfield, you tell them bits and pieces. Like,
so what, this is the really thing I think I want to get out of you here. All right, now, like, what, you know, you're going after these people. You say that Desert Rose has been saying all of these horrible things about your friends. Now, what do you want Desert Rose to do?
I want Desert Rose to come on my show, speak to me, and see, and just wondering why they are making my friends, my friends, Amanda B. and Faberday, they were my first people in my chat room, and I welcomed them. But no, I want Desert Rose to figure out why in the heck she's mad. Why in the heck is she attacking Faberday and Amanda? And here's what Faberday says. Tell them that those we were lesbians only BC. I put a flower image on the screen to Amanda to say good night to her. Oh, a flower on the screen.
Oh, so that's why Desert Rose thinks that they're lesbians.
I want to speak to Desert Rose. I'll put her to shame. Oh, I don't care about them and what they think. You know,
maybe,
what?
Would you be happy if Desert Rose apologized?
You know what? If Desert Rose apologized, she really needs to mean it. And she really needs to grovel on her hands and knees to Faberday and say, Faberday, I'm sorry for what I said. I did not get all the facts. Because you know what? That Prankville USA, that Tom Morrison, loves making people's lives a living heck.
Now, he's a little crazy, I think.
He is so crazy that, you know what? I hope that Spreaker come March 1st, we'll shut down half of the people on this speaker. I want Desert Rose, I want Tom Morrison, I want Goofy Bones, I want Angela Truth to be shut down permanently.
Permanently?
I don't want them to ever come to Spreaker again.
Wow. I mean, well, I don't think that's going to happen.
I know. But I wish that could happen, because I don't want them to come to Spreaker. We want to make Spreaker a good place here. I'm trying to make Spreaker a good place. But these four individuals are causing so much drama and so much hurt and so much pain to me. That and to my friends in my Skype and to my friends in my chat room, that I cannot take it. I will fight and I will win. Trust me.
Now I gotta ask you here, who was the one who Todd Morris is going after?
Todd Morrison is going after Faberday.
Okay.
And Todd Morrison thinks that Faberday and me are girlfriend and boyfriend. And that's not true. It's not.
Right.
It's really not that true.
You know what you can do? I mean, I think what you should do is, you know, prepare. Don't actually file it. But what you should do is prepare all of the appropriate paperwork with the proof, you know, the evidence.
You know what? It's not worth it. It's not all the... It's not worth it for me. It's not worth it. You know what? If they want to, if these hear people, sorry.
Yeah, hear me out on this one.
Okay.
You prepare all the paperwork and everything as if you're going to file a complaint to, I guess, you know, Spreaker or whatever it is, you know, about this. And then you say to Desert Rose, all these people, you say, listen, I am going to file this complaint against you unless you apologize and leave Spreaker.
You know what? It's not going to work. They're going to call my bluff, and I'm not even going to do it, because if, you know what, let me tell you something, and I screwed up your name, news guy. I put NES.
Oh.
Sorry. Let me tell you something. I'm not going to follow any paperwork. I'm not. If they want to make fun of me, want to make fun of my show, they can. That's it.
Okay.
If they want to make fun of my show and my friends and my Skype, fine, they can. But you know what? There's one thing that they will never have, these four people.
Okay.
That is, there's one thing that they will never have.
Okay.
And I'm going to tell you that. The one thing that they're never going to have are fans. Because my fans, believe me, I do not stab people in the back. I don't stab anybody in the back. I don't. You can testify to that. I never stab anybody in the back.
I think sometimes, you know, you do get caught up in, like, the emotion of things, and then things, you know, just things just get carried away. And I think that's what happens to you.
Uh-huh. You know? I get carried away, okay?
Yeah.
And I can admit that.
Get carried away with the emotions of, like, whatever the circumstances are, you know, something's going on in the chat, somebody's calling in on Skype, all of these things, and you just kind of lose the sense of, like, right and wrong and everything, and then you just start going a little, you know, and it's funny, it's good stuff, but, you know, people get hurt by that.
Yeah, but you know what, it's funny because when, oh, wait a minute, hold it, time out, I want to say hi to somebody. Someone came into my chat room, and okay. I want to say hi to, Caroline? C-A-T-H-E-R-I-N-E.
Catherine.
Well, hello, Catherine, how are you doing? Welcome to Speaker, my friend. Catherine is in the chat room here, ladies and gentlemen, so Catherine, welcome to my home. Thank you for stopping in and chatting with me and the news guy here. So I'm glad that you are rocking and rolling here. News guy, please continue with the questions.
So, oh yeah, I see. You said it's time to talk with the nesguys. You got to change the title there.
I know. Who's the nesguys?
Well, that's what you wrote here on the title here. It's time to talk with the nesguys.
I know. I'm like, what the heck?
Well, you know, did you ever see that TV show WKRP in Cincinnati?
No.
Oh, it's a classic TV show about a radio station in Cincinnati, Ohio. And the news guy on the show is this guy named Ness Lesman.
Well, don't worry. I will change the thing. So, do you have any... So, Peter, so continue with the questions here.
Yeah. So, all right. So, anyway. So, that's what I'm thinking. So, Catherine is in there and...
Faraday and Amanda is in here. We are having a... Big thing, and I know that Canada won over the U.S. hockey team. You don't have to bring it up, okay? I know that Canada won, but we're still in first place with the gold medals, baby. Ha!
Well, actually, I'm not too sure if that's correct. Isn't it that Norway has more gold medals?
I do not know. The last time I checked on Fox Sports Radio, it was USA. Norway and Canada all tied for first place.
All right, you know what? We got to settle this bet right now. Let me look at this. I'm going to Google it.
Fine, let's go.
All right, say Olympic, hold on. Olympic gold medals. I guess we can see, like, how that, maybe that'll come out. Russia stuns with Olympic gold in women's figure skating. U.S. shut out. I guess they're just talking about that now. Let's see here. Michaela Schriffen wins gold in slalom. I don't even know what a slalom is, but let's see here. All right. Canada beats U.S. 1-0. Oh, my God. That's horrible. I can't believe that. That's a catastrophe. Don't you think, Andy?
Yeah. You know what? The funny thing is I had my money on Canada.
Oh, you're a traitor to your own country.
I know, but I had my money on dang Canada. I'm sorry, but I had my money on Canada, baby.
No, this is horrible. I can't believe that you're actually betraying the United States
hey,
of America.
I like the United States of America, but I had my money on Canada.
You're the Benedict Arnold of the Sochi Winter Olympics.
Hey, I can admit I'm proud. Okay, now mine. Norway is in first place.
That's what they're saying here.
Norway is in first place, then followed by Russia. Then followed by Canada, and the United States is in fourth place, ladies and gentlemen.
Right. Yeah, this is the problem. Looking at this, Norway is the number one winner of all of this. They're coming out on top. And Norway has only, like, 500,000 people or something.
Mm-hmm. So, well, anyway, let's get back to the, sorry.
Oh, you want to get back to the drama? I think that the drama's kind of played itself out, unfortunately. I don't think there's really anything else, you know, kind of beating a dead horse at this point.
Uh-huh. News guys, so what is, how did you become how's your battle coming with Cowport Radio?
Well, you know, it's kind of at a stalemate right now. Cowpoke has done a couple of podcasts. I haven't heard all of them. He's gone after me because I said that my use of his audio on my show was fair use. Because, you know, the guy is now going after me. He's saying, well, you know, he played my audio without my permission. So I say, well, you know what? I used it because it's fair use. You were talking about me on your show, and I have to document this for my show to show that I'm not doing some sort of a lie. You know, so it's fair use, pal. And if you don't like it, that's too bad. So then he goes on for like 45 minutes talking about fair use. He's saying that I'm stealing gas out of the gas station, all this kind of stuff. So, you know, I got to fight back somehow. You know, what I'm thinking is that this guy, Cowpoke, he really is just in support of this gay black athlete. I think that there's something weird going on with the guy over there about that.
Well, what gay black athlete?
I don't know, this guy Michael Sam.
Michael Sam? Who the heck is Michael Sam?
I don't know. He's like some guy. He's going to be drafted in the NBA or some of the NFL or whatever it is. And they're going to be putting him in there, and he came out as the gay. And they got a video of him.
Is it Michael Stan or Stan?
I don't know. It's like Michael Sam. I think it's Michael Sam.
Well, let me type up.
And so he's doing his shows, and he's putting these big pictures of this guy up on his show, and he's like, I'm in love with Michael Sam. That's what he's saying. Now, you know, so I don't know. There's something really weird about this guy, Cowpoke. I think he's getting too many fumes from the airplanes at the airport.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's what's going on with the guy.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's interesting because you know what? It's really, really, really interesting.
Yes. Yeah. Well, that's the whole problem with this. I mean, I'm just going to have to get down to the bottom of this. I'm going to have to call in the Cowpoke show. I think maybe this weekend, if he's doing a show, I'll have to call in. I don't know when. I'm not going to announce it because it has to be a surprise, complete and total surprise. Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Amanda has to go and gotta go and have fun. Okay, Amanda B, thank you for stopping into the chat room here. Have a wonderful day off with your, with your daughter, ladies and gentlemen. Have a fun day off with your daughter. So, hey, can you do me a favor in Tennessee? Can you play me a Tennessee song here? Because we were playing Dirt on, I got a song for Amanda B to head out. So I'm sorry, I have a song for Amanda B to head out to. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is for Amanda B heading out, ladies and gentlemen, out of my chat room.
And Andy, I'm going to end the show now. So, but I want to thank you for coming on and giving us the extended breakdown of everything.
Hey, you can still be on my show if you want.
Okay, but I gotta wrap up my show first, so I gotta, you know, hang up on you, and I'll be calling you back. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Speak to you later.
Bye, buddy. Here, ladies and gentlemen, Amanda B for you, Bacon Red Silver Horse Rider Cowboy. Dum da da dum da da dum da da dum da 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 da. Dum da da dum da da dum da da dum da 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 da.
Out $100 bills, and it kills and it thrills like the horns on my Silverado grill.
And out by the bar, double round of crown, and everybody's getting down in this town. Ain't never gonna be the same. 'Cause I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise 'cause the girls, they are so pretty. Riding up and down Broadway on my old Studley Roy, and the girls say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody says, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Well, I don't give a dang about nothing. I'm singing and bling blinging while girls are drinking. Long necks down, and I wouldn't trade old Leroy or my Chevrolet for your Escalade or your Freak Parade. But I'm the only John Wayne left in this town. And I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise 'cause the girls, they are so pretty. Riding up and down Broadway on my old stud Leroy, and the girls say, save a horse.
That's what she said in the back of my truck bed as I was getting buzzed on suds out on some backcountry road. We were flying high, fine as wine, having ourselves a big and rich time, and I was going just about as far as she'd let me go. But her evaluation of my cowboy reputation had me begging for salvation all night long. So I took her out gigging frogs, introduced her to my old bird dog, and sang her every Willie Nelson song I can think of, and we made love. And I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise 'cause the girls, they are so pretty. Riding up and down Broadway on my old stud Leroy, and the girls say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody says,
what is up? We are back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Andy Bond. It's great to be in this in the great state of Green Bay, Wisconsin, ladies and gentlemen. I have Faraday in the house. We have Breen. I know I'm gonna screw up some names here. I'm sorry. We have Breen and Ed Rena. I can't even read it here. Hello. Wow, I can't read to say myself. I'm sorry that I'm screwing up the name here. Cool, you love country, me too. Wisconsin. Yes, I'm from Wisconsin. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Oh my. What, you're from Wisconsin too? Okay, Cat. I can't even say names today for some reason. Ben and, I can't say names here. I just need some help here. It's Adam Adraena. Wow, I can't even read. Hello and welcome to the official DTR speaker episode. Live weekday 7cc with NRB 30 minutes of interesting topics. Sorry, I can... Thank you. And I'm sorry that I can't. I'm sorry that I'm screwing up your name here. Wow, okay, wow. I think Faraday is working out, ladies and gentlemen. Holy cow. Hey, Faraday, if you're gonna. I'm just gonna call you Ad. AD, Ad. Okay, I'm just gonna call you Ad. Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have already rock and roll. If you want to call in, if you have Skype, Skype lines are open. Andy Bond Show, one word, ladies and gentlemen. Andy Bond Show, one word. I'm typing in this in my Skype chat right now. Bond Show, one word in my Skype. If you want to come on my show, you can. It is internet. It's Friday. Thank God it's Friday, right, ladies and gentlemen? Andy Bond Show, one word. Come on my show and let's chat. I'm going to have the news guy on as soon as he wraps up his show. Here, ladies and gentlemen, let's see if he wraps up his show already. And no, he's still going on, ladies and gentlemen. Holy cow. Wow, he is still going on. Okay, why is there two Faradays? Why is there two Faradays? Sure, you can go on. Why is there two Faradays, ladies and gentlemen? My Skype is Andy Bond Show, one word. You can come on my show. Okay, so we have two Faradays here. Okay, Faraday 1 and Faraday 2. Okay, that's just scary on so many levels. It is. What's the Skype? Andy Bond Show. Andy Bond Show, one word. What is up, Hell's Riser Radio? You think? Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's time to rock and roll here, ladies and gentlemen. We have turned it to, we have so much stuff, it's unreal here. Oh. Cool. Got it. You can come on and say hi. Cool, and I heard you too. Yes, the world can handle one Faraday, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, my name is Andy Bond. It's time to rock and roll here. We have so much stuff to cover. It's unreal. So, let's see if the news guy is still on. Holy cow, the news guy is still on, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. What is up, Brian Silver? How are you doing?
I am doing good. This is Bren.
Bren, sorry. Hello. Holy cow. I'm screwing up names today.
All right. It's fine. It's Adriana, just so you know.
Adriana. That's what it was. Okay, now I got it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Ben and Adriana is on my Skype right now. If you want to check out the show, go right ahead. It's a cool show. Let me go to their thing and let's plug it in.
Yes.
If people can stop talking for about 5 seconds here, it's like hard to go up here and talk because people are just talking here.
Yeah.
Holy cow. I never knew how my okay. I'm gonna do a shortcut. Okay. I'm doing a shortcut, so don't tell anybody, okay?
That's cool.
So tell us about your show. What show do you, so tell us about your show.
Well, it's a talk show that me and Adriana started. Adriana originally got me started in it, and she told me that I should stop being lazy and get into, like, something. And I'm like, oh, okay, well, Spreaker sounds fun. And she's like, yeah, so we get going on Spreaker, and we actually got followers really fast, and, you know, I actually like Spreaker. I've grown to like it a lot. We talk about interesting topics every day. It's kind of random, you know, we have random hour and all this good stuff, so it's pretty interesting, and I think everybody likes it, you know. We've got good reviews. So, yeah.
472 followers, 1,549 plays. Okay, seriously. You're taking over my show. Wow, okay, seriously. That's uncool, dude. I'm just joking. So, Brian or... what's your name?
It's Bren.
Bren and Adriana.
Yes.
I know I'm going to screw that name up 500 times, so FYI, I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay. It's cool. Yes, but I think it's a really cool show, and I think everyone likes it, you know.
Well,
yeah, people who are listening to the Andy Bong show, keep listening to him until, like, he's done with his thing, and then come listen to ours. Don't leave him.
Don't worry about it. You know what? We're all Spreaker family, and I'm just joking with you, okay?
Hey,
all right. We're just joshing you, okay? We're just friends here, all ladies right. and gentlemen. We are just like one big Spreaker family. We do each other's shows, for example. So, ladies and gentlemen, random stuff I cannot wait to hear it because it's going to be interesting. So, ladies and gentlemen, as soon as my show is over, do not go yet because my show is not going to be over until, I don't know. I really don't know when my show is going to be over. I wonder if I can drag this on long enough.
I don't know. I think you can see it on the top of the page if you're recording. But, yeah, so it's pretty cool. So, you said you'd take a shortcut to my show or...
Here's what I did take a shortcut to your show. It says, ladies and gentlemen, hello! It says, hello and welcome to the official DTR Spreaker episode live weekdays at 7 o'clock CST, Central Time, right?
Yep, Central Time. So,
where are you from, anyway?
I'm one state next to you, so I'm Minnesota. So that's why that's...
Boo! Viking fan!
Yeah, you know, I like I really like to visit there. I've been there a lot.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Minnesota, and wow, if a Minnesota Viking fan and a Green Bay Packers fan can get together, anything can happen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, 7 p.m., 7 o'clock, wow, I can't talk today. Help me here.
7 o'clock, Central Standard Time.
So are you brother and sister?
We're best friends.
You are, so you just do a show together.
Because she said, as best friends, we decided to do the show together, and I think it's pretty cool, to be honest, you know.
Well, that's cool. Well, explain what your show, what you're going to be talking about today.
We came up with this new bit. It's called, Comment Fridays. And Comment Fridays is where Adriana starts singing some song, and I have to comment on it, you know,
Like this? Like, the sun will come out tomorrow, just about...
Like, stuff like that, you know, like, while you're singing, I have to, like, say, well, you know, like, how you were singing, the sun will come out tomorrow, I have to say, well, hopefully it does, you know, or, you know, something like that. I have to get the topics, don't tell her this, but I haven't thought of anything yet, and it's 6:36, I need to come up with something.
Well, you know what, the best way to come up with a topic is, okay, what topic do you think is a fun topic to hear? Go in my chat room. Hey, type in my chat room, what topic do you want to hear from this show?
Type to the Andy Bong show and have them send in topics. They need to be six topics.
Well, I can tell you, I can think of six topics already.
You can? What are they?
Well, wrestling, cars, girls... Green Bay Packers, Minnesota Vikings, States.
Cool.
And, yeah, that's it. Some topic. I'm sorry. Just click on the chat. Bubble. You on your show now. Playing screen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we're just having a fun time here. 6:37 here. Why don't you hang out with me until you want to... Why don't you hang out with me?
The Olympics, that's cool, and, I'm having fun right now on your show, Andy, right now. So, you know, thank you for inviting me onto the show.
Hey, don't worry about it. Anytime. Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my name is Andy Bond, and I said this before. It's time to talk, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to be talking about all kinds of stuff. I'm really, really upset about Canada beating the U.S., but you know what? I had my money on it. I'm a trader, I know, so give me a break here. I know that I'm a traitor.
You're not a traitor.
But I had money on Canada, too. I don't know how I said that Canada is going to beat the United States. That's still a mystery to me.
Yeah.
I was just making fun of stuff, and I don't know how I do not know how I did that.
When did you start your show?
Well, I started in... The first time I started my show was in 2000 and... I want to say 2007?
Oh, cool. I started in July of... Oh, my God. July of 2013.
Well, cool. So, yeah, I've been doing my show so... And I like it because you can, it's so cool. I had to literally delete my account 500 times just to get the right formula.
Oh, wow.
Because I just have to delete my account and say, Exec FM Radio News Talk Worldwide, what is up, Peter? How are you doing? Hey, why don't you come on my show now? Okay, jeez, are you done yet talking about the news guy here? Jeez, how rude.
Thank you, everybody, from the Andy Long Show giving me topics, and thank you, Andy, for having me on the show.
So, tell me your name one more time, because nobody knows who your name is in this chat.
Okay, it's Bren. My name is Bren.
Well, check out the Bren and Adriana show at 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock Central Time. I'm going to be, wait a minute, hold it, time out. I got a question for you.
Yeah.
Do you want me to broadcast your show for my show?
We could do that. I'll talk over with Adriana. How late are you staying on?
I can stay as long as I want here. I have a 3-hour show.
We will. I'll talk to Adriana about it, and then we'll give you a Skype back when we're ready.
Okay, let's do it.
Thanks, man. Talk to you later.
See ya. Well, that was Ben and Adriana's show, ladies and gentlemen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, news guy, come on the show now. You can. If you want to, you can come on my show now. Jeez, I've been waiting for you here. Jeez. Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Annie Bond, and we're going to be talking about all kinds of stuff here. Wow. I cannot wait, so let's play some music here, and we'll be right back on the Annie Bond Show.
You got to go.
Welcome back. This is the Undead Bond Show, and we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Let's rock and roll, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Let's have some fun here. Fair Day is working on, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, we need to... Okay, on for the Fair Day using, Fab Day working out, say I. I'm joking. But everybody needs to lose weight. Exercise is a good idea. I would advise you, if you are, when it's nice out, go outside, run, jump, play, do all kinds of stuff here. Exercise is very important to us. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have so much stuff to have some fun here. It's time to talk with the news guy here, and I'm waiting for the news guy to come on my show again, but I really do not know when he's coming on my show, and it's really ticking me off right now. But when the news guy comes on my show, they can, okay? The news guy can come. Let's see where the news guy is right now on this thing. The news guy is done. Cool. Well, I'm going to call Peter Goodman right now. Well, when Peter Goodman wants to come up again here, ladies and gentlemen, they can. So what's new with you, everybody, here? It is 6:46. Tick-tock, tick-tock. The Brian and Adriana show is coming up at 7 o'clock p.m. And, wow, I cannot wait. Okay, seriously. Okay, let me do some, let's do some statistics here, ladies and gentlemen. I love statistics. I can't even talk to today. Sorry. But everybody, ladies and gentlemen, here's my, I have 924 followers, 5,214, okay. And Adriana is 470, wow, okay, seriously, that is impressive. Well, I do have some of these. Actually, I can play some of these disco if you want me to. Okay, I'm on YouTube, I'm sorry, this is, 70 disco. Disco music hits. Let's see. Wow. Any particular song? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play a random some of these disco music here, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, let's see if we have any workout music. So many distos workout music. Yeah, the trainer is like, I swear to God, the trainer is going to look at me saying, "Moron, why are you doing that?" We have 80s disto, we have 70. Oh. Workout music disco. Dance ecstatic. Okay, I'm just going to do the locomotion. I'm just going to do the locomotion and be done with it. This is, okay, I'm just going to play the locomotion. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Kyle Moore in the locomotion. Okay, everybody, let's do the locomotion.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's the KC and the Simpson Band. Get down tonight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was KC and the Sunset Band. Get down tonight. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Earth, Wind, and Fire, September. Here's September, Earth, Wind, and Fire.
As we dance.
That was Earth, Wind & Fire, September! Baby, that was a nice one. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my name is Andy Bond, and we are live from the Green Bay Studios here, ladies and gentlemen. Brian and Adriana is going to be coming on in 3 minutes. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to be broadcasting this show. I'm going to be broadcasting Brianna and Ariana's show on my station. So, stay tuned. I'm going to be broadcasting this thing. So, I'm going to give this, these two people a run for my money. Brianna and, wow, okay, seriously, they are doing good. I can't wait to hear their show here. I can't. I am looking forward to it. So, ladies and gentlemen, while we wait for the show to start, ladies and gentlemen, let's have some fun here. So, ladies and gentlemen, all controversy went up in smoke last night, and so I'm having a blast. We have brand new people here. I haven't done this in a while, so let's go and see who's following me here. Haven't done that in a while, so I am really, really, really good at that. So let's see who's following me on my shows here. Followers. Okay. We have Amanda Branshone, 36 followers. We have The Late Night Kill, 11 followers. We have Martin Bill Hansen, 0 followers. Chuck Playground, 3 followers. Blur Vision, 1 follower. Eric Stone, 1 follower. Christopher Gibson, 0 followers. ACOG, 0 followers. Avrin Jasmine, 0 followers. We have Michael and Gabe, 0 followers. We have Russian. We have Reason Devetti, 0 followers. We have Tina Davis Powell. We have Reese Bingham. We have Brian Adriana, 473 followers. We have Linka, 50 followers. We have Sun Cowboy, 69 followers. We have BG, 0 followers. We have Franken Manestro, 1 follower. We have Paris Brad, 0 followers. And we have Susie, 0 followers. And the list goes on and on here, ladies and gentlemen. Holy cow, I have so many followers. It's unreal, so I am so thankful. Yum. Okay, I'm really hungry right now. So, ladies and gentlemen, 1 minute left. Let's rock and roll here. We're going to play a short music break, and we'll be right back on the Andy Bond Show. American Noise by Skillet. Enjoy!
Angry words and honking cars, satellites and falling stars, distant dark blue radios that whisper down my boulevards, ghosts and chains rattle in the attic, broken headphones filled with static, lonely room, you've got nowhere to run. 3, 2, 1 for all and all for one. Times will be bad, times will be good, things I wish I hadn't done, and somehow wish I would. Cutting through the American noise, you've got a voice, and a song to sing, and a song to
Hey everybody, my name is Andy Bond, and what's up? Long night ahead. That's my Friday night. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I know it's a long night ahead, ladies and gentlemen. It is so hard to make it through the weekend here. Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Andy Bond. That's right, the one, the only Andy Bond here. We're waiting for Brianna and Adriana to come in and do their show, so I cannot wait. So that's going to be interesting. I cannot wait. I'm looking forward to it. I am so much looking forward to the show here. I can't wait to hear it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have no clue what to talk about. All the stuff that I got out on it was on the News Guy show. That was it. So I have no clue what to talk about anymore. Well, let's see what's in the news today here. This is a news show, right? Let's see what's in the news today. We have Bing. Let's go to Bing. Well, let's see. Idol's top 13. Wow. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. American Idol has meet your top 13 finalists, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's rock and roll here. We have the 13 American Idol people that's going to make it to make it. So, the question is, who do you think is going to win American Idol? The top 13 are, top 5 girls are, Melissa Watson, Emily Pritch, Jessica Mez, Mystery, Majestic Rose, McKay Nopakin. Wow, I can't read. Top 5 guys, Ben Bradley, Alex Peterson, Dexter Roberts, Caleb Johnson, and Sam Wolf. Judges, wild card is Jenna Arenazzo, Kristen O'Connor, and CJ Harris. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be that's going to be the toughest judging I've ever seen in my entire life. I can't wait. American Idol, I cannot wait. So, American Idol, you rock. I cannot wait for American Idol. I love American Idol. I love singing, too. I just love singing. That is my favorite thing to do, singing. For the longest time, whoa, whoa, whoa. When it was said and done, the top 13 season XII were revealed, while 10 lucky hopefuls were told they were headed to the final five. More contestants had to battle and out 3 wild card spots who advanced. Who was eliminated? Take a look back at the thrilling conclusion of American Idol. Rush Reek. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's interesting because it's time to rock and roll. Who is going to win? That's the $1 million question. Who's going to win?
You just unwrapped all your presents on Christmas morning. Should you start with the pop-up ice gun or the electric cat roller coaster? Trick question. You should start with both. Delicious.
That was a Coca-Cola episode here. Here's the... I really don't want to do all the rest week here.
Right now, the 13 empty chairs on the stage are reserved for your top 13. Those names will be revealed tonight. The first person to make it in to the top 13 is... Malia Watson! Congratulations! Ben Riley, let's go, Ben! Emily Paris. Alex Preston, you're right. Alex, let's go. Jessica Mews, let's go, Jessica. Dexter Roberts, let's go, Dex. Caleb Johnson, let's go. Majesty Rose, let's go, Majesty. MK Nova. Sam Wolf.
There's 10 people left. Of the 10, we're going to choose 5 to sing tonight. So then we can pick three of them to fill those seats there in the back.
You know
I don't know what I should address first, the fact that the band screwed that up or you screwed that up. Both of y'all did. It was not a strong start.
And when they cheered for the big high notes that we all do, you stayed right where you were. You didn't let anybody affect you. You just stayed in that moment. That's a really good artistic sign right there, baby.
You know, I'm not sure that that was what I would have wanted America to see right now. I know it's up to us in this moment. We're going to talk about it and see how it goes. He was
You definitely sang for your life, but it was all over the place.
When the crowd kicks in, you know what I mean? Like, you can sing a little bit higher because you were struggling to keep it where it was. You could have liberated that a little more, but your voice...
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's right. That is absolutely right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, No Talent Reject is right. Let's talk about fame and fortune and how it crumbles people, ladies and gentlemen. That's another thing we can talk about. Okay, thank you. Well, it is No Talent Reject, but ladies and gentlemen, it's hard to be a celebrity. It is so hard to be a celebrity that you have to do everything. Like, let's take Miley Cyrus, for example. Miley Cyrus is an interesting person. She is. She is the nicest kid on Hannah Montana, but all of a sudden turns into one wrecking ball psychopath that rides a wrecking ball naked. And I don't get it. Why in the heck does that happen? Why does that happen to people's, that people's, hey, we're live, they're live. Well, let's listen to Ben, Brianna, and Adriana.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Like, you know,
you made a girl. What?
Just ban them.
No!
Honestly, that's mean. Okay, well, yeah, you know, so it's...
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what you do, what you're hearing is, you have no sound. It's like it stops halfway, and so what happens is that when you have no sound, it hurts, and so I cannot hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, they did all right. I'm surprised. They are doing actually all right. Let's listen to some more of this stuff. They're doing all right. Okay, I am gonna cut that thing out because they're coming in and out. They're cutting in and out. So, ladies and gentlemen, what is going on in today's news here? Because it's unreal. Loser keeps Beaver. Okay, I gotta see this. Team Canada knocks off the American men and women's hockey team and the Chelsea Winter Games, and now it's the time for the U.S. square its bet. Canada beats USA. Okay, I gotta hear the bet here. I gotta hear the bet. That's funny. Oh my gosh, that's funny like hell. Oh, good. Okay, here's the thing. Update: the U.S. versus Canada. U.S. lost. Beal, it's stuck. It's stuck with the Beeb. Okay, update: the outcome of the boat hockey matches have been determined to the glee of the U.S. neighborhood in the north. Canada's prime minister Stephanie tweeted that he is looking forward to his brew. Like I said, a good bet. I look forward to my two cases of beer. Oh my gosh! Rumor has it that he's our won't bet ever. Beaver. Prior to the men and women's hockey team, the already heated ice hockey rivalry between U.S. and Canada had reached Olympic promoter, epic amongst Olympic promotions, with the U.S. and Canadian women's hockey team finishing battling it out for the Olympic gold medal Thursday, and the men facing off in the semifinals Friday. The leaders of both countries were waging a friendly bet for both games. This from Canada's Prime Minister. I'm betting hashtag one case of Canadian beer prior hockey game this week. It's good bet we are winter. Go Canada, go at White House. Now, the White House at Prime Minister, I bet on the women's and men's U.S. hockey team winner gets a case of beer for each game. Go USA. The tweet billboard picture, however, just took those stakes to a whole new level. Loser keeps Bieber. Oh my gosh. Okay, seriously. We don't want Justin Bieber. Where is Justin? What's going on is, crap. We have Justin Bieber now. He is from Canada, but now the Canadians don't want him. The no-tail reject Justin Bieber is not welcome in Canada anymore. Seriously, that's just sad. Well, sorry. That is just too sad that Canada doesn't want Beavers anymore in Canada. So we are stuck with Justin Bieber. Crap. Wow, okay, seriously, we are, no talent. We are stuck with Justin Bieber. Canada doesn't want Justin Bieber. We are stuck with Bieber in the United States of America. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have Justin Bieber. We have Justin Bieber now. That's funny. Oh my gosh, that is so much funny right now. It's unreal. Oh, I'm having a heart attack right now because I'm laughing so hard. Well, I am going to cut this show off because nobody is in my chat room here. They're just, wow, okay. Let's see what's going on in my, wow. Seriously. I'm not a bad guy. Okay, we got it. We are back, ladies and gentlemen, on the Andy Bond Show here. Let's see who is in this chat room here. Well, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. What? I am not talking that loud. Am I talking that loud? OP, what is up, my friend? How are you doing? OP is in the house. What is up, ladies and gentlemen? It is cool to see you in my chat room, OP. What is up? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play some more music. This is Na Na Na. Hey, hey, goodbye. Wait a minute. Hold it. We have a... I'm okay, Andy. I'm glad that you are okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's do the broadcast show here. Let's do Oompoos. Children of Son Billy Thorpe. Who's Billy? Oh, wait a minute. I know who Billy Thorpe is. Son of a gun. Don't tell me who. I know who Billy Thorpe is. I know who Billy Thorpe is. That's the sad part. I like Billy Thorpe. I think, oh, never mind, that's not the guy I'm talking, never mind, Billy Thorpe is not the guy I'm talking to, never mind, sorry. You're right, Justin Bieber's, holy cow, okay, seriously, Justin Bieber has had zero good songs? I do not know. Let's see, baby, yeah, what are Justin Bieber, can you name Justin, that's a trivia question, can you name Justin Bieber's greatest hits? Well, I better get going, so this is the end, so saying bye.